It's AumSum time!
What if we only eat spicy food?
Nothing will happen. I eat lollipops every day.
Oh, AumSum. Eating a moderate amount of spicy food does have some advantages. Firstly, spices definitely increase the flavor of the food we eat. Secondly, some experts believe that capsaicin found in spicy foods helps in weight management by curbing our appetite and speeding up our metabolism. A study also found people to be more satiated after eating spicy food. Thirdly, capsaicin has anti-inflammatory and antimicrobial effects, which are good for our body. Disadvantages of eating too much spicy food are, firstly, they can decrease the sensitivity of our taste buds. Secondly, they can cause acid reflux. That is, acids and spices mix with stomach acid and irritate our food pipe lining. Thirdly, they can cause irritation of our gut, leading to diarrhea. Lastly, they can further worsen heartburn, stomach ulcers, and condition of people suffering from irritable bowel syndrome. Is spicy food bad for you?
Obviously, because whenever I eat spicy food, my mouth seems to be on fire.
This is because spicy food generally contains chili peppers. Chili peppers have a chemical called capsaicin. When capsaicin comes in contact with our tongue, it activates the heat-sensing receptors instead of our taste buds. As a result, our brain thinks that our mouth is on fire.
So, shall I call the fire brigade?
Oh, just listen. Capsaicin present in spicy food is not necessarily bad for everybody. Only those people who have a low tolerance level or don't have a habit of eating spicy food can experience some problems like burning mouth, irritation of the stomach lining, heartburn, etc. Topic: human nose. Why does spicy food make your nose run?
Because it is not that strong to make me run.
Nah.
Huh?
Our nose consists of tiny hair and a sticky substance called mucus.
Can I use this mucus to stick my broken vase?
Ooh, gross. Huh? Please don't do that. And listen, during breathing, the hair and mucus trap harmful substances, thus prohibiting them from entering deep inside the body.
Huh?
Now, spicy food items like chili, mustard, horseradish, and wasabi contain chemicals called capsaicin and allyl isothiocyanate. When we eat such food items, the capsaicin and allyl isothiocyanate travel through the pharynx and reach our nose. Here, the chemicals activate the heat-sensing receptors, thus causing inflammation in our nose and irritation of the mucus. Hence, as a defense mechanism, more mucus is produced in our nose to get rid of these chemicals, thus making our nose run. Are canned foods safe?
Huh?
No, just pizzas are safe.
Oh, some. Canning is basically a method in which food items are processed and then packed in airtight containers. This helps preserve food for longer periods. However, there are some disadvantages of canned foods. Firstly, canned foods can be high in sugar and salt, so they can pose a risk for people with high blood pressure, diabetes, obesity, etc. Secondly, most cans have a coating of bisphenol A to prevent corrosion. Studies suggest that bisphenol A can leak into the food and have negative effects on our hormones and reproductive system. Thirdly, the acids present in food can react with the metal can and produce hydrogen gas, creating bulges, thus making food unsafe to eat. Lastly, improper canning process can lead to growth of dangerous bacteria called Clostridium botulinum. It produces a lethal toxin, which if consumed, can paralyze our muscles and cause death if left untreated. Is expired food safe to eat?
No problemo. I'm as strong as Hulk.
Oh, some. Usually we see three types of dates on food products: sell by, best by, and use by. Use by is what we call the expiry date. Consuming food past this date may prove to be harmful. Firstly, the nutritional value of the food will reduce. Secondly, as bacteria don't usually grow at low temperatures, many foods are frozen. But if foods are kept at room temperature, bacteria will develop in them. Now, if consumed, they can cause vomiting, diarrhea, food poisoning, etc. Thirdly, it is believed that when canned food expires, the acids present in food react with the metal can and produce hydrogen gas, creating bulges in the can and thus making the food unsafe to eat. So, expiry date is definitely a good indicator. But apart from that, we should also rely on our senses of smell and sight to check the quality of the food. Is fermented food good for us?
No! French fries are the best for me.
Alright, now listen. Fermentation is a process in which natural bacteria and yeast break down the sugar and starch present in the food, producing lactic acid and other compounds. For decades, fermenting was a technique to preserve food. However, nowadays, fermented food is getting a lot of attention because of the benefits it provides. Firstly, as the fermented food is pre-digested or broken down by bacteria, these foods are easier for us to digest. Secondly, fermentation increases the nutritional value by producing beneficial enzymes and vitamins. Thirdly, as microorganisms break down lactose present in the food, lactose intolerant people can eat yogurt and other fermented milk products. Lastly, fermented foods contain probiotics, which are good or friendly bacteria. They improve our gut health, thus leading to a healthy immune system.